If we turn the pages of Indian Constitution, first we encounter the preamble. It is more like a preface to a book. Preamble serves the following purposes. Number 1. It discloses the source of the Constitution. It starts with "We the people of India." It says that people enacted the Constitution for themselves. Number 2. It says that the Constitution was adopted in its final form on November 26, 1949. Number 3. It set out the rights and freedoms which the people of India wished to secure for themselves. Number 4. It declares the nature of the government. It wants India to be a democratic country where the government is for the people and by the people. It also wants India to be a secular one, that is, the state does not have any religion. After preamble, the contents of the Constitution of India is divided into parts. Each part deals with a major topic. All the parts are written in point form called articles. Let's have an overlook on some parts of the Constitution and its subject matter. Part 1 talks about the name and territory of our nation. It states that the name of our nation is India or Bharat. It also states India as a union of states. The territories of India and the ways of formation of new states and alteration of the name, area and the boundaries of the existing states are all described in this part of the Constitution. Part 2 of the Constitution deals with citizenship. It classifies the persons who became citizens at the commencement of the Constitution, that is January 26, 1950, and the ways of acquiring citizenship after January 26, 1950. Part 3 of the Constitution talks about the fundamental rights guaranteed to the citizens of India. The fundamental rights guaranteed under the Constitution are classified into 6 groups. Those are right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, finally, right to constitutional remedies. Part 4 of the Constitution contains the directive principles of state policy. These directives aim at the establishment of the economic and social democracy in India. It shall be the duty of the state to follow these principles both in the matter of administration as well as in the making of laws. Part 4A talks about fundamental duties of the citizens. Part 5 of the Constitution deals with the Union Executive, Union Legislature, Union Judiciary. It describes the election, qualification, term of office, procedure for impeachment, emoluments and allowances, powers and duties of the Union Executives such as the President of India, Vice President, Council of Ministers, Attorney General of India, Comptroller General of India, etc. Under the Union Legislature, the functions of Parliament, Constitution of Parliament, composition of the Council of States, that is Rajya Sabha, composition of the House of the People, that is Lok Sabha, are described. Further under this section, method of election to the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, duration of Houses of Parliament, sessions of Parliament, motions and resolutions, qualifications for membership of Parliament, disqualifications, powers, privileges and immunities of Parliament and its members, legislative procedures, bills and its types, budgeting process, parliamentary committees are all discussed in this part of the Constitution. In the same way, the state's executive, legislature and judiciary are covered under Part 6 of the Constitution. Part 9 and Part 9A of our constitution discusses about composition, duration and powers of the panchayats and the municipalities respectively. Part 10 of the constitution talks about administration of scheduled areas and the tribal areas. Legislative, executive, financial and administrative relations between the union and the states are discussed in Part 11 of the Indian Constitution. Elections are dealt in Part 15 and emergency provisions are dealt in Part 18 of the Indian Constitution. Part 20 of our Indian Constitution describes the procedures for amending the Constitution. When the parts of our Constitution are over, we will have schedules. A schedule is a part of an enactment that contains additional information that has not been mentioned in the body of the legislative document. Schedules are an appendix attached to enactments. The schedules are kept separate and not included in the original text of the Constitution because it contains lengthy informative details which are more than 100 pages of a document. Initially, we had 8 schedules. After the amendments, now Indian Constitution contains 12 schedules. Let's look at some of the important schedules. The first schedule deals with the name of the 29 states and their territorial jurisdiction. It also contains the details regarding the respective laws, acts that determines the boundaries of each state. The second schedule covers the provisions for emoluments, allowances, privileges of the following: the President of India, the Vice President, the Governors, the Speaker, Deputy Speakers of Lok Sabha and States Legislative Assembly, the Chairman, Deputy Chairman of Rajya Sabha and States Legislative Councils, the Judges of Supreme Court, High Court and the CAG. The fifth schedule contains a provision relating to the administration and control of scheduled areas and scheduled tribes. The sixth schedule contains the provision relating to the administration of tribal areas in the states of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, and Mizoram. The seventh schedule deals with the division of powers between the union and the state in terms of three lists. List 1, Union List. It has 100 subjects. The central government has exclusive right of legislating on the subjects mentioned in the Union List. List 2, State List. Presently, it has 61 subjects. The state government has exclusive right over these subjects. List 3, Concurrent List. It has 52 subjects presently. Union and the state have the power to legislate on the subjects mentioned in the concurrent list. However, in case of conflict, the law made by the central government will supersede. The Schedule 8 comprises the list of languages recognized by the Indian Constitution. It had originally 14 languages, but now there are 22 in total. The 9th schedule was added by the First Amendment Act of 1951. It says that the laws included under the schedule are to be protected from judicial scrutiny on the ground of violation of fundamental rights. Originally, the 9th schedule consisted of 13 acts dealing with the land reforms and the abolition of zamindari system. But presently, it has 282 acts. The Schedule 10 deals with anti-defection law. Schedule 11 and 12 are about panchayat and municipality. On 1949, 26 November, the Constitution of India was passed by the Constituent Assembly. On 26 January 1950, it came into effect. Indian Constitution had 395 articles, 22 parts and 8 schedules at the time of commencement in the year 1950. Currently, the Constitution of India comprises 470 articles in 25 parts and 12 schedules. There are 104 amendments have been made in the Indian Constitution till the date.